Now let's come back to our homework example and think of, are there any sources of exogenous variation? So generally think about what are the reasons why students could differ in the number of homeworks that they submitted. And we already discussed maybe students' general ability and diligence and try to control using prior average grades as proxy. But what other reasons can influence the number of submitted homeworks that are not perfectly controlled by this proxy? So to mind come, for example, how much time has a student in the semester? So how much course does he take? So how much time has he to work on the microeconomic problem sets? Or how much does a student like or is good in this microeconomics course compared to other courses in the previous semester? So maybe he really likes microeconomics and therefore he submits all the homeworks. But if you think about these two factors that come to mind, probably all of them can also influence the exam grade. So if a student has more time to work on the problem sets, he probably has also more time to directly learn for the exam. Or if he likes microeconomics more, he will also directly learn for the exam. So these sources of variation that may not be perfectly controlled by the previous grades also rather seem to be confounders instead of sources of exogenous variation. And actually, in this example, I cannot really think of any obvious source of exogenous variation in the number of submitted homework problem sets. Probably all the sort of variation comes from some confounders. I can try to control for some of the confounders, but that does not help if the remaining variation is also confounder, comes from other confounders, and I really don't have any source of exogenous variation, then I really cannot get a well unbiased estimator. Yeah, so if we look at this regression again, where we control for some confounders with the previous grades, even if you think this is a pretty good proxy with little noise, if we don't have any clear source of exogenous variation in the number of submitted homework by students, we don't have any idea whether this is really has a low bias. It could be largely biased in our estimator, and it's also not so clear in which direction it is biased once we have some proxies, but it's not really a convincing empirical strategy running this regression alone to estimate the causal effect of an additional submitted homework on the exam score. Indeed, actually, for this data set, I don't see any plausible empirical strategy to consistently estimate the causal effect of solving one more homework on the exam score, because I don't know that there's any source of exogenous variation. And unfortunately, that is the case for many non-experimental data sets. It's often very hard or impossible to consistently estimate some particular causal effect because we don't have any source of exogenous variation, or even if we have it, we cannot control for all confounders. So this is very common that we cannot estimate a particular causal effect we are interested in. That's a little bit sad, but that's the way it is.